गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू द एसक्यूएल क्लास अगेन. सो टुडेस टॉपिक इज कैलकुलेशन एंड फंक्शंस. ओके, सो दिस कैलकुलेशंस एंड फंक्शंस आर जनरली यूज्ड विद द सेलेक्ट स्टेटमेंट एज वेल एज इन द ऑपरेट स्टेटमेंट. नाउ वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट द सेलेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, सो वी विल सी हाउ दिस फंक्शंस आर यूज्ड इन with the select statement and how we can use simple calculation or while we can simply calculate some attributes or values using the select statement. Okay, so first come to the functions. In case of the function, we have different kind of function, but for today's topic we'll go for sum, average, mean, max and the count function. Sum function, average function, minimum function, maximum function and the count functions. Okay, so first is the sum function. As all of you know, the meaning of sum, that is finding the total of a particular value or a set of values or a range of values, for finding the total of a set of value is known as the sum. So here the sum function in SQL is used to find the sum of all the rows of a particular attribute. That means in a particular column, whatever be the value stored in that particular column, finding the sum or total of that column can be done using the sum function. Not only the total number of rows, if you are using condition, then we can also find out the total of some rows or some limited rows or some required rows. Okay, so here I have written two kind of sum statement or sum using select statement using sum function. In the first step, suppose we want to find out the salary of all employees, that means the total salary given by the organization to all the employees. In that case, we have to write down select sum. Sum is the function. Within a pair of parentheses, you have to write down the column name or the attribute name for which you want to find out the sum. So in this case, we want to find out the sum of the salary. That's why I am writing select sum in bracket or in parenthesis salary from empty, and that is the termination of the command. So the command is select sum salary from empty. So in this case, what happened, it will display only one column having the total amount given as salary to the all the employees. Okay, suppose we need the total value for some of the employees. Suppose we need the salary given or the commission given to the salesmen only. Okay, in that case, just you have to write down the where condition with this function. Simple thing, select sum commission. In case of salary, you can use commission or salary or any numerical value, you can find out the sum. So here select sum commission from EMP, and after that in the second line, or you can continue in the same line also. So in the second line I have written where job is equal to condition. So here we are mentioning a condition, that is job is equal to a salesman. So in which rows the job is the salesman, that means the salary of all salesmen will be added and the total number of salary has been displayed as in case of your when we are using the where condition. Okay, the same thing happen in case of average function. Okay, that is used to calculate the average of the attribute. Okay, same thing, if you want to find out the total average, what is the average of the total employees, then we can write down select average salary from EMP. If you want sum of the employees, then we can write select average salary from EMP where department number is equal to 20. So that in the second case, in this case what happened, if we find out the average salary of all employees, those are working under department number 20. Whereas in the first case, it will be display this average salary of all the employees of that particular company. Okay, then two functions are there. One is the max function, another is the min function. Okay, the max function is used to find out the maximum value of an attribute or of a particular column, what is the maximum value or the highest value stored in each row or every row. Okay, and the minimum function is used to find out the lowest value that is stored in a particular column. Okay, here also you can use with condition or without condition. If you want to find out for the total number of rows, then you should not use any kind of condition over there. And if you are using condition, then you can find out the minimum and maximum for a particular categories of value or a particular set of value or limited rows. Okay, so let's go for the example. The first example was for the max command, max function, that is select max salary from EMP. Okay, that means it will display what is the maximum salary given to among all the employees, what is the maximum salary. But in the second case, what happened? Select max salary from EMP where job is equal to salesman. In this case, out of the salesman, which salesman is getting highest salary, that much will be displayed. Not the name of the salesman, the amount given to the highest amount given to the salesman as salary will be displayed in the second statement. The same thing happened in case of mean function. In case of mean function, what happened? It will display the lowest value. The same thing I have written over here. Select mean sal from EMP. That means it will display the lowest amount that will given as salary to the all employees. And in the second case, here I am writing something different. Select mean sal from EMP where hired date greater than 03 September and 2018. Okay, here as a date field, I am using condition over here. The same thing happened. It will display the minimum salary or it is display the lowest salary. For whom it will display the lowest salary? Where the hired date is greater than 3rd September 2018. That means those employers who are joined the organization or were hired by the organization after this particular date, that is 3rd September 2018, will be displayed. That means among those employees only it will display what is the lowest salary. Okay, so these are our four function, and the fifth function is the count function. It is a little bit of different from these three functions. Okay, this function is simply used to count the number of rows. Number of rows depending upon null values, number of rows depending upon values, or number of rows depending upon a particular attribute. Okay, let's see what are the three kind of command we can use with the count statement. Okay, now suppose we want to simply count how many rows are there in a particular table, or how many tuples or how many records are there in a particular table. In such case, simply write down select count within a pair of parentheses. You have to mention asterisk. I told you about asterisk. Asterisk is nothing than all the attribute. That means it will count for any attribute. Not only all the attribute, it will count for any of the attribute. That means in a table, if any attribute has any kind of value in any row, it will count one. And the second and the third and the fourth and like so on. So in this particular statement, the select count asterisk from EMP, it will display simply the number of rows or the number of tuples or the number of records present in a table. Okay, now suppose we want limitize or want to reduce the number of rows or use for limited number of rows. If you have remembered the employee table, okay, in that employee table, the commission given to only salesman. If you notice the employee table, the commission column, whatever be the commission column, in that column only 4 and 5 values are there, and those who are working as salesman, they are only getting the commission. And the rest of the row, the commission value is null. It is not zero, it is null. I told you about null value and the zero value. The zero is also an amount. The zero is also a value stored in a particular row. But if we skip the row inserting the value, then it will take null value. And in the commission field, what happened? Except the salesman's, all other values or all other job getting null value in the column commission. Okay. So suppose I am writing now the statement. What happened? Select count commission from EMP. Then if what happened? It will count the column of commission only. Rest of the column has been removed from the query. It will count only the commission, and in this case only 4 or 5 commission salesmen are there. If you remember the employee table, then only 4 salesmen are there. That means it will display the result as 4 only, where the commission column has some value that may be any number or that may be 0 except null. Okay. So when we are mentioning a particular attribute or a particular column in the count command, then it will search on that, or it will count on that particular column only. Rest of the column will be removed, or rest of the column will be ignored from the query. Okay. Now come to the third thing by using a particular condition. Now what happened in the next? I am writing select count star from EMP where job is equal to analyst. Okay, it is very much simple to understand. Here it will first check the condition. If job is equal to analyst, then only it will count the value. I think in the EMP table there are 3 analysts are there, so the result of this query will be 3, because it will first check the condition and in which row the condition is satisfying, it count as 1. In the second row, suppose the condition satisfying, count 2, third row, count 3, and like this. Okay, so these are the different functions which can be used with the select statement. Okay, now come to the calculation part. You very much know about the arithmetical calculation, plus, minus, multiplication, and division. So, no need to explain those calculations, but how can we calculate the values using the select statement on the attribute? Okay, again come to the EMP table. In the EMP table, we have 2 columns. One is sal, that is salary, another is com, that is commission. Okay, so these are 2 different salaries. Suppose you want to display the sum of commission and salary of the respective rows. That means in each row it will be displayed the sum of commission and salary given to that particular employee. Okay, so in that case what happened? I am writing this select ename EMP number commission, salary plus commission. Okay, one more thing I am using, I have already used over here, that is the column name. Instead of the asterisk, I am using the column list or the attribute list over here. So what happened here? Select ename EMP number sal plus commission from EMP. Okay, so what happened? It will display the column ename EMP number and sal plus commission. That means the output of this particular query will be displayed like this. Suppose ename EMP number sal plus commission. Okay, suppose the first employee is John. Suppose EMP number is 2750 and is getting salary as suppose 700 and commission as 50. $700 is the salary and commission is 50. So in this column it will display 750. Clear? Yeah? Okay. So what happened? Ename EMP number sal plus commission is equal to 50. Whatever be the value that adding the sum, adding the salary and the commission will be displayed over here. Okay. Now, one more thing we can use with the calculation, that is the edge clause. The edge clause can be used with the calculation. Okay, so what happened here? In case of the as clause, it used to give a temporary name or a else name to the column. Okay, in the previously whatever in this particular query, sixth number question, it will display the column heading as salary plus commission, which is not looking so good. Suppose we want to give a name to this particular column on the display board only, on the query output only, it will not store in the table. Remember this thing, it will be not stored in the table, it will be displayed in the result only. In that case, we can use the as clause. Now see how can we use the as clause. Look at the query number 7, that is select ename EMP number sal plus commission, same as query 6. After that, I am using the clause as. Add salary from EMP. That means the sal plus commission will be displayed as salary. So in this case, what happened? The result will be like this: ename EMP number salary. Okay, whatever be the value, John, suppose 2750 and 70. So this is the only difference, used to name a column heading in the query. Okay, it will be not stored in the table. Now the last thing about this functions, we can use some values with the attribute also. Okay, now what happened? Look at the second last one, that is select ename job salary plus 500. Okay, salary plus 500 as net salary, I am writing over here. If you are not using this as clause as net salary, and here I am using the condition also. Without having condition, what happened? It will display for all rows. In this case, it will display for only the clerks. Okay, so what happened here? The output will be ename job and suppose sal plus, in this case it will be displayed as net salary. Okay, suppose so ename is suppose John, job is clerk, and the salary is 700 and plus 500 I am written. That means in this case it will display 1200 as net salary. Okay, and here it will display only the details of the clerk. And if I am not mentioning this much of thing, then what happened? It will display for all rows of the all the tuples. And if I am not writing this net salary as net salary, then what happened? In this case, it will be displayed sal plus 500. Okay, so these are the functions and calculations that can, those can be used by used with the select statement and the use of as clause also, I told you. So this much for today. I think you can able to do all these things using your MySQL or SQL or Oracle, anything like that. Okay, for that, thank you and have a nice day.